We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
How hot are they?
Hear them, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah, I can hear it. It's hot, man.
There you go.
Another edition of the Women Empowerment Program, and this, you know, of course, I had a woman, but I'm a sexy individual.
There you go. Yeah,
exactly. You know, I'm your host, Big Dre, and to my left, my main man,
Vaneric Marshal.
Yeah, but TJ over here.
We have TJ, and let the ladies introduce themselves.
Go ahead.
Well, you know, TJ, back again another week. That's it. I really don't have much to say besides that.
Okay. And then to your right.
Your right.
I'm Splashy. I'm back here again. Thanks for allowing me to be back in the presence.
All right, Splashy. Right. Welcome.
And then you
welcome.
Got then you got to your far right, one of your sons, right?
Yes, I have my son Cameron here.
Cameron, pull that mic closer.
Pull that mic over and talk about you a man. It's about a battle of sexes thing about the women and the men in America. How us men empower women.
Yeah, don't be scared.
Don't be scared now.
Don't be scared.
As a young man. I'm going to get mad out there, big man, Matt Man out there.
Long Beach in the house, Long Beach in the house.
All right, LBC.
Okay. LBCC.
So, your young man, you see the NWA movie yet? Did you see it yet?
No, I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, so we saw it yesterday.
I'm planning on it.
I commend anybody, black, white, Mexican, whatever, to go see that movie. It's the inspiration to
Dr. Dre. Yeah, he's trying to get his ears right there.
Yeah, Dr. Dre. Dr. Dre, my boy, my good friend, F. Gary Gray, man. I remember F. Gary Gray was just starting off producing. He had no film school experience. That's all raw talent. Well, hats off, man, to him.
Oh, the one who played
the director.
The director.
F. Gary Gray, he didn't go to school. He's a phenomenal man, phenomenal brother, man. And he put this thing together. So I give his hats off to him, Dr. Dre and Ice Cube. And his son O'Shea Jackson did a great job, my boy. Oh, we got a haircut.
So that's Ice Cube's real name, O'Shea.
Yeah, O'Shea Jackson, man.
O'Shea. Yeah, O'Shea. That sounds African.
Junior. So his son, is a good friend of mine. We get a haircut at the same barber, and that beard's the same barber.
Right.
And when he said he was playing his dad's part, like 4 months ago, before all this stuff happened, I'm almost a year ago he was about doing it, but he didn't know he was going to be playing it. Phenomenal job, and the guy who played EZ did a phenomenal job. But our show is basically about women empowerment. We're talking about how, on a man's point of view, how we deal with dealing with women who are of empowerment, and how do men feel on the men's side about having a woman president for the first time in American history. In other countries, they have women president. South Korea's president is a woman. And she has a female bodyguard detail that runs her detail along with the men as backups. So that's how much faith she have in her all-women staff. That's why I always stress the fact that any young lady in America, how to empower themselves as individuals and stay strong, because I have nieces, I have sisters who've been domestic violence victims, and that's why I started my Archangels all-female bodyguard team, to show the world that I could take any person walk of life and turn them into elite, you know, protection machine. And I did it, and I accomplished it, and I'm proud of myself. And the television show is coming. We're in development right now. We're doing, so it's going to be hot.
That's good.
You know, all female soundtrack. It's going to be bananas. So nothing against us brothers out there, but I'm going to do an all girl female soundtrack for my TV show.
Is that going to
be? That's awesome. That's good. So, that's going to be a blessing.
Oh, it's going to be hot. You know, and I'm talking to MC Light. Hopefully, Light say hey. And him help produce it. It'd be crazy.
Yeah.
I get involved with it. Oh, so yeah. That's how it's going to be. But what do you women think? What needs to make America shift to that moment of having women that's to keep empowering it? So what makes you want to go out there and empower more women that with a man backing company that can say, hey, if I have a female that's up for the position of a CEO of a company because you know, he want to retire, would that be a good move if she has 1 year less experience in the male version who may have that 1 year experience of her, but she have a better track record? Would you want to hire her as a CEO?
Actually, I would want to hire her and give her a chance because if she has a better track record, then you know, she has potential to boost up the company. But you know, we live in a male-dominated society, so it's really hard for women to, it's a lot harder for women to, you know, have that opportunity to become top of the company or, you know, whatever it is. But I think women's first, they need to be able to, you know, be strong themselves, not show any weakness. You know what I'm saying? That's the one part, you know, the Bible says, you know, women are the weaker vessel. But I think women need to be strong and show men that they can do whatever, you know, they put their mind to. It's a little harder for women to prove their point. They might have to do more work, but it can be done, you know. Women need to tell men that they, you know, they have to be respected and show that. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Show that in the way they talk, the way they dress, and they're in the presence. You know, carry yourself with confidence, and people will respect you.
Exactly. Yeah, so, Beth, what's your input on that, Beth? What do you think?
I just feel women is powerful. We can organize things, put things in order. Once we focus into whatever we want to do, we can be very powerful into it. And I feel any woman could do whatever she want to do in life.
Okay, well, that's good. So, young man, what do you think about this? And you've been the mother. Now you knew your mom was a district manager, for instance, somewhere. And she had the power to hire. Would you want to work on your mom's tools?
Yes,
just
I will.
Being at home with your mother,
yeah,
every day. You know, my mama's running. Yeah, but you're my boss too. You know, most kids look like that. Man, I can't work with my mom and dad, but I worked with my dad for almost 20 years, so I can work with my family. No problem. Man.
Yeah, because checks and checks. You know, like family is family. You know, and it usually be the dude, but it's no women could do anything a man could, God could do. Because
yeah, exactly. Right. I'm glad you look like that because I feel. In a battle of how we feel things. I mean, just like your input, Van, what do you feel like? What are some of your different pet peeves? Now, we're going to the pros and the cons here. What's your con, something you do with some women you have dealt with?
Well, being that my mom's raised me from the age of 5 to manhood, she gave me the opportunity to know what it is to, not to be a woman, but to see what a woman has to endure in a man-dominating society. Mm-hmm. And I was able to pass that on to my daughter. Because I had male influences, that also helped me because, again, she is, my mom, like all women, are the creator of man. Because you know they give birth to the world. So with that said, they do play a very important part of that. The devil's advocate side, and going forward, women have to understand that. We have a place. The men have a reason for being here too, so they have to understand they can't be a man. They can make they can be on the same level as men, but they're not men. So, like you women have a passage to womanhood, and you pass that on to the young ladies, to the girls as they're growing up. Boys, we don't have, the men don't have that anymore. The men doesn't show the boys the passage to manhood, so it's left upon the women to try to give that passage to their sons. And a lot of times they may come up short because they're not men, so they don't know what that boy might be going through. So that's playing the devil's advocate. We men have to take their sons, and learn and teach them the passages of manhood, how to really be a man. Because a woman can teach her son how to treat women. But it's going to be very difficult for her to teach her son to be a man. If you understand what I mean by that, because it's a big difference.
Yeah.
Treating a woman is one thing for a boy to learn, and it's very important. but to be a man is another level. And like I said, I'm not saying that a woman can't do it. I'm saying that it's very difficult. It could be very difficult for her to really have a son, to teach her son how to be a man on certain levels. So that's playing the devil's advocate, if that's what you're... Yeah.
That's true. That's
well,
true.
You know, I look at it like this, like we were talking earlier, how sometimes women, and some men the same way, they take this empowerment and it goes to their head. So I've seen women like in control, but then when you have a different outlook of being, I have a badge, like those only police officers, I have female police officer friends who used to hang out with me when they was, wasn't even becoming cops. Some, a lot of them, I influenced two female officers to become officers. One's in the U.S. Marshal Service and one's a cop, and she don't even hang out with me no more. She don't call no more. She don't talk no more. And it kind of really disturbs me that when you was trying to make that that PT test and try to make that wall, I went back to that wall with her and helped her climb that wall. And we tried for hours. She just could not make it. She only had one day or she wasn't passing the police academy. And I rode her butt like it was like, I said, I'm going to tell you what, I'm the man on the other side of that wall. I am coming to rape your whole entire family, all your daughters, and you're going to watch me rape your daughters. If I get through this wall before you, get over this wall, I'm going to rape your family. I think you're the biggest, I call everything sluts, everything. The motivator to get over that wall. You going to steal that wall? And she sat there and she cried. I said, why are you not hitting that? I said, we're going to do it in the morning, do for it. Your shoes are slippery, but it's the way you approach the wall. And after I ride her, rode her so much and told her, you ain't got no empowerment for women. You make, you let every woman down. You can't even make a wall. It's, it was like the laughing stock. After her fifth try, she hit the wall so hard. And then when it came to PT testing, on her first try, she hit it, bam, was over it. She flew over the thing. So all she seen was anger and saw me laughing at her, saying all the people laughing at her, saying, see, another woman can't do a simple little test. And gonna be all, totally two female in that whole class become a sheriff, made that that class that year. Her and another girl. The other girl was a beast. So it was like, you know, so if I can motivate any woman to be to do right, no matter what it is, that's what I'm going to do, what God got me here to do. If I can't do it, you know, I'm not going to give up. Because I think every woman deserves that right to do whatever a man wants to do if God puts their mind to it. And I wish these younger generation, these young men understand, when I see a young man walk in front of a woman, it's the most disrespectful thing I've ever seen in my life. I see a man on the streets walking on the inside and the woman's on the outside, I just like, oh, my God. My friend be like, what you laughing at? I said, man, I just see... If I jump that curve, the first person to get hit is that woman. And then me and Van were talking about how these dudes do that. They don't realize that's the most worthful sin when you let a man walk on the inside of a woman on the sidewalk. And they want to understand what the whole... And the old saying, like, when you get in the car, your date, and you put her in the car first, then she don't reach around open the door for you. Right. You don't be the love you at it. My mother told me that one time. I said, that ain't true. I said, wait. Yep, it is true. It is true because she won't even do it. You know, well, it made me a ham sandwich. So, you know, and that's how it is. You know, I mean, how do you guys feel about Hillary running for president?
You know, Hillary, I mean, it's good that a woman is running for president, but I think America really looks at what Clinton, Bill Clinton did and all of his works and because of her husband, you know, are willing to vote for her and not really basing it on what she herself has.
I don't know. I don't know if she's going to win. I don't know. I think that this Bernie Sanders dude, I went to a rally with him about a week ago. I got invited to. This old man, 73, and he got the 24-18 Rachel vote right now. It's Bernie Sanders. He leading right now on a Democratical primary right now for the being. So I don't know. He got a, like 8-point margin over right now. Wow. So I don't know. This old man, he 137 years old, become president, but I don't know about that. You know, her winning that bid because America like may see that shadow of Bill Clinton. You know, it's sad, but. 8 years of Bill Clinton, they did a female version of Bill Clinton. You got to ask yourself that. So what do you think?
I believe Hillary, she would do good as a president for us because basically her husband, you know, he did an awesome job and they, you know, birds of a feather flock together. You know, so I truly believe that he has implanted some things into her to be able to run this country, you know. So I think she would do a good job. I'm definitely going to vote for her. That's who I'm going to vote for.
Exactly. Okay.
You know, well, so we need a woman in the house.
Yeah, I think
about
so.
Time. Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't doubt her ability to do the job of being the boss or CEO of this country. What's going to happen is what males won't or will refuse to work with her. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, it's going to be obstacles that she's going to have to maneuver around, over, and sometimes have to go through, because there's going to be certain people that's not going to make it easy for her. She's they're going to discourage her as much as possible, be a thorn in her side, because they can't fathom of a woman in being in that position. Mm-hmm. And because of the history of the United States, the white male has been running that position and the positions that follows along with that. Mm-hmm. So just like with Obama, being that he's a minority, there was a lot of people who didn't want to work with him.
Mm-hmm. They still don't.
They still don't want to work with him, and not and refuse to work with him.
Yeah,
you know, they'll act like they're working with him, but in their long run, they're not really working with him.
Yeah.
So that's what's going to happen, mm-hmm. whether she wins the election this time or whatever. So. I'm quite sure she's capable of doing. A lot of women are capable of handling a high pressure job like that.
Mm-hmm.
Is that unfortunately, because this is a male dominant
society?
Who's going to be willing to, you know, not bow down, but accept the fact that this a woman has the authority over him?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
In a different country.
Yes.
For Rutenhouse.
So what we're going to do, because, you know, this topic is the battle of the sexes and stuff like that, we have yet to give out the phone number for those who may be listening and want to call in and participate. The call-in number is
323-473-3100.
Oh, so, yeah. You know, we're going to go to a break because we got other
we got
people
new panel
coming on in here.
Talking about some things.
And you're listening to Veterans Day Live
with your host,
Big Dre.
And my main man, Vaneric Marshal and TJ, our co-host.
Hey.
And so we're going to have fun today.
Smash.
You know, this is the ladies' show. So, you know, we're going to play some type of
Beyonce
songs.
Excuse
and all that.
Donna
so
Ross.
We have a request for Beyonce, but we'll probably come in there on the way back.
Oh, yes.
So stay tuned for
I
more.
Leave this, you have Miss Myrlene Chapman at the helm when I leave and come back. Back at 2 and 2.
See you later.
Do you or does someone you know have sickle cell disease? Have you heard about the EPIC study? It's an international research study evaluating an investigational drug aimed at shortening the duration of painful crisis. And with over 50 sites in the U.S., there may be a site near you. To learn more and to find out if the EPIC study is right for you, visit www.theepicstudy.com.
SoCal NOMA.
Exactly 25 years ago, the United States welcomed 54 million individuals with disabilities into the workforce. And today, even more opportunities exist.
Hi, my name is Dan Jamal Cooper, and I specialize in job placement for individuals with disabilities. I advise on laws, employee rights, and regulations for disabled workers. Meet Rick and Amber Boggs, a visually impaired couple who don't allow their disability to overcome their drive to create jobs for the community.
Dan Juma has been an integral part of our business success, and I believe he is an asset to any business or individual.
Together, we can empower your community and enrich your business. So remember, when it comes to making your business work, make the change today. The Disability Awareness Experts.
SoCal NOMA, the Southern California chapter of the National Organization of Minority Architects, is hosting its 6th annual 3-day summer camp on 3 consecutive Saturdays in August, August 1st, August 8th, and August 15th, for young people ages 10 through 16. Campers will enjoy a 1-day field trip to iconic architectural buildings throughout Los Angeles and 2 days of hands-on building design experiences, including how to use a 3-dimensional computer software program. The total cost of the camp is just $100 per camper and includes lunch, snacks, and it lasts all day from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. To learn more and to register, please go to SoCalNOMA.org. That's SoCalNOMA.org and click on the Camp NOMA page. SoCal NOMA, proud sponsors of LA Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Network.
Hubert's Lemonade, tasty, refreshing, sweet, and tart. Happiness in a bottle. Visit Hubert's Lemonade at hubertslemonade.com. Once again, that's hubertslemonade.com. Happiness in a bottle.
You're listening to the Vaneric Rock Show. I'm your host, Vaneric, daily, Monday through Friday, here only on LA Talk Live. We're more than just talk.
Hi, this is Araceli inviting you to join us every Sunday at 2 p.m. for Veterans Day Live. Join us as we provide info that will help all military personnel. So don't forget to tune in to Veterans Day Live every Sunday at 2 p.m. exclusively on latalklive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, Radio Flag, TuneIn Radio, Live 365, AHA Radio, Table Radio, and Apple TV Radio. Or just watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hello, I'm Joel Ramirez.
And I'm Lolita Robinson Coppage, and welcome to Joy in My House
on LATalkLive.com. Inspirational radio
with a touch of recovery.
A reality show where nothing is left unsaid
and no one is insignificant who says it.
Exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV.
Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hey, this is Trisha Mann Grant, and I am inviting you to join us every Sunday at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for Gospel Rhythms, Heaven's Party here on Earth. And join us as we talk to the Christians, just not any Christian, but all Christians of entertainment and all walks of life. Don't forget to tune in to Gospel Rhythms, Heaven's Party here on Earth every Sunday, 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, Live 365, Radio Flag, TuneIn Radio, AHA Radio, TiVo Radio, and Apple TV Radio, or watch and listen directly at LATalkLive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Mm-hmm. Lucy Liu with my girl Drew, Cameron D and Destiny, Charlie's Angels. Come on,
come on. Bring it.
Question, tell me what you think about me. I buy my own diamonds and I buy my own rings. Only ring your celly when I'm feeling lonely. When it's all over, please get up and leave. Question, tell me how you feel about me.
All right, coming, we're back. Hello, everybody. This is Veterans Day Live. Today is Women's Day, you know, empowered women.
We got a whole
day? Yes, exactly, you know. We got a whole show.
Hey,
a whole hour show just dedicated for you, man. And I'll give a brief reason why I decided to have a format for military women. Farron and I was invited to a red carpet event in Beverly Hills. It was a documentary on women in the military and sexual harassment. And that inspired me to want to have at least a segment or at least an entire show for the women of the military, because they've been overlooked in the way they've been treated.
Military sexual trauma.
Trauma, exactly. So
MST.
Yes. So I made sure that I said, I want to do that. I want to actually have a platform for women of the military. That's how it started off first. And then God pointed me in the direction of, well, all women should have a platform to speak from. And that's something that, as a military person myself, signed up for, to protect America. And if I'm serious about protecting America, so I have to protect women as well, women, children, and other men. So without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and give it back to it, because we have a phone call, and I see the phone call. So hold on there, phone caller. We'll get to you.
Already.
But I just want to hand it over to our panel. So I'm somewhat bad with names, but so I'm going to just go ahead and let everybody introduce themselves over again. So go ahead, from my right to the left. Speak a little fast. Don't be scared in the mic. Get in there. There you go.
My name is Myrlene Chapman.
Okay, and you?
Background. A little bit of background.
A little something, something. Give us something,
background.
You know, give us something, something.
Something. And I don't have a military background, but I've worked at the VA hospital in Long Beach, so with a lot of, the veterans, and so it was really passion. I was a co-leader for the PTSD group.
Oh, you can relate.
And so definitely. Right. So I could relate and understand all the information that we were talking about tonight.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Hey.
How you doing, Miss Brooks? Yeah, I know Miss Brooks. Brooks was a long time family of LA Talk Live. So I was very surprised when I saw her walk through the door. So
well, you know, Marilyn called me and said, you know, come on down.
I need backup.
Yeah, like, come on down. Like the price is right. Come on down.
I need backup.
Yeah. Well, I'm Brooks Jackson Colyar. I'm a producer and a former and soon to be again. I'm bringing my show back in October. I was host of A Necessary Conversation talk show focused on women empowerment, actually.
There you go.
And I have not been in the military. However, I had the privilege of taking a comedy show
exactly
to Iraq, Afghanistan, Kuwait, and Baghdad, and two times. Wow. I've went over there, and it was amazing.
Yes.
Recently, if I could just have one more moment.
Go ahead.
Recently, I embarked on a project because I've been reading about women sexual harassment and homeless women who have been fighting for us, and now they come back and they don't have any place to live.
Exactly.
So my project now, and LA Talk Live is going to be a big part of that. Mm-hmm. I have a show called It's Not That Time of the Month, as you know.
Mm-hmm.
So glad.
That's right.
So glad it's
well,
not.
Well, it's an all-female comedy show, and the reason I gave it that name is because of the stigma that goes with that time of the month. It's not that time of the month. We are here to have a great time. We're here to entertain. No bullshit. No nothing. It's all about fun and empowering women, hanging out with the military. I want to do this show. I'm trying to get into every base in the United States.
Okay.
And from the shows, the comedy shows that we do, we will donate the money, all the money from the shows, to an organization in that community that's helping female women and women in the military.
Oh, yeah.
So every penny that we raise, we will be giving back to them. And we'll get paid through sponsorship. You know, I have an amazing team of women that are going out with me, and you know them all. And we look forward to, you know, just coming on the show and doing a whole lot of things with this. So thank you for having me. And my show is slated to start in October.
Boom.
A necessary conversation.
All right. Now, next, Splash.
Okay, I'm Miss Splashy. I'm here representing the Dog Pound, DPG.
All right.
I'm Snoop Dogg's niece, and I'm also here to also discuss about the West versus East mixtape that I want to come up with.
Okay.
I'm also here to represent all the unsigned artists from the West to the East Coast.
Boom.
I want to be able to give them an opportunity to be heard.
Wow.
So that's what I'm here about.
Oh, I need to talk to you.
And we all need to talk with
you. Exactly.
Okay.
And then go ahead. Any more?
I'm done.
All right, go ahead, Farron.
Let's see. I'm Farron Dozier. I'm a retired Sergeant First Class, United States Army. Served 24 years protecting this country, and now I advocate for sickle cell traits, sickle cell disease, lupus, you name it, chronic illnesses. I have arthritis. I was depressed 2.5 years, so I know what that feels like, tastes like. So it's working on humanity now.
That's so great.
I do a show here, WDC Radio, every Saturday at 4 p.m., and I do Sports Lounge Live with Ilya that you met at 2 o'clock every Saturday.
Right. Exactly. And we're going to get to this caller right now.
Bring the caller on.
Whoever this is. Caller, what's your name? Where you calling from? What's your personal comment?
Hello? You talking to me?
Yes, I'm talking to you now.
How you doing? This is Pat Fuller. I was calling in. I was calling in support of Splashy. I wanted to find out a little bit more about the mixtape. The East versus West, or West versus East.
When the East is in the house.
Okay, definitely. I have a few artists from the East Coast as well, which is War Child from out of Philly that will be featuring. I have artists on the West Coast, which is Big to the Boy from Compton, Dog Pound Echo. They'll be representing as well, who's on the phone now, Pack Fuller. You will be included as well in that. So I will be getting in contact with you.
Now let me ask you, is this only rap or is it R&B?
I'm open for R&B and rap as well. I just wanted to be the hottest mixtape. A lot of artists need to be heard out there.
Absolutely.
Who hasn't been heard all over the United States. So that's my goal, my passion, to push that and let it be known.
Now, do you have like a launch or a like a date that, like, say I have an artist that I'm definitely going to talk to you about?
What's the
perimeters that you're looking for?
The beginning of 2016 is my goal to push this mixtape. So right now it's in effect of working and getting established, and then the beginning of the year is when I want to have a release date for this mixtape.
Yeah, so we get to release it right here, LA Talk.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Exactly. Exactly.
That's 9 million viewers.
You know that.
Go ahead. Go ahead, caller.
I'm sorry, because my time is limited. I just wanted to call in and offer some support in Splashy's project. Contact me. Let me know whatever we can do. You know, we have a small studio in Downey, California as well. And I have a lot of artists who will probably want to be contribute to the project as well. Okay. You know, nice little talent. And anything that I can do will help out too, far as... If you need any help with making the production of the music, I'm sorry.
All right, I appreciate that. I appreciate that.
Well, thank you, caller, for doing all that. We have your contact information. I'll pass it on to Splashy. So this way, in a later date, she can get in contact with you and you can collaborate with her.
Okay, and I'll continue listening because I'm interested to hear about the sickle cell information as well.
No problem. I'll pass it on to Farron, your contact information as well, so he can get your information, email address, whatever the case may be, and you can. And he'll get
one.
Okay.
Thank you.
Appreciate the love.
There you go. So, you know, it's all about, you know, as Big Dre pointed out, the battle of the sexes and stuff like that. So, you know, why do you think some men are intimidated by women that's empowered and go by the beat of your own drum and know what you want and know where you want to go? Whoever wants to start that, whoever. I'll just put it out there.
Shortly, I'll say something. I think it's because men traditionally are raised to be in charge, to be the head of
the household.
Of not just the household, but the head of whatever they're involved in, they're the head of it. So when a woman comes along with the same skill set, she can do it all and more, and then she rises above. It's kind of intimidating and it's threatening because that's not what they're accustomed to. Men, and it has started, I believe, need to change the way they view women. We're not just barefoot pregnant in the kitchen anymore. We're in the boardrooms. We're in the White House. So
yeah.
Start looking at women, and not as equals, because I would never want to be equal to a man. That's a whole different ball game. Yeah,
exactly.
But respect women for what they do and what they've accomplished, and I think it would be easier on them to relinquish some of that fake power that's in their heads.
Exactly.
And let it go. It's not, you know, we're not trying to take over. We're just trying to do our part.
Exactly.
Right.
Anybody else?
And I think it's, there need to be a bond of unity. And it's, like Brooke said, it's not a power. It should not be a power trip or anything like that. We all should work together as a unity, side by side mm-hmm. with each other, and don't have any struggles of a power trip or feel intimidated, you know, if a woman with her head up high. And we've gone through a lot to get to where mm-hmm, we were,
definitely.
To where we are now. And because us women, we are stronger than sometimes a man could think of and everything. We're not just childbearing,
right.
You know, and a man cannot deal with the pain of childbearing. And
no.
God give us that, you know, for women to bear children for a reason. We could, you know, cope with that. And so looking at that type of situation, and we don't just take care of the family, but, you know, our partner and by our side, and to make it equal, raising the children, household and working, some of us now, I mean, us women now, we have all that title.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. It was a while back. Somebody did a survey or something like a survey. The position of the so-called housewife, how much her salary would
yeah.
be if she,
exactly.
you know what I mean, if
wow.
if she was getting paid
wow.
To be a housewife, and it was, you know, in the hundreds of thousands
absolutely.
Of dollars
absolutely.
A year that this, you know, like that.
So I'm going to speak from my perspective of that conversation in two ways. First of all, communication. Really, you have to be able to have, even if your boss is a female, there has to be some level of communication. And most of the time, in the environment that we grow up, like you say, mm-hmm. that the parents broke, the broken communication between the father and the son and the mom and the son is probably broken. So we don't know it. They don't know how to communicate.
Yeah.
So to even have that initial conversation is broken.
Yeah,
and then so
true.
By me being in the military 24 years, being, you know, in charge of female soldiers, and also having a soldier, female soldier in charge of me, no problem. My mentor for sickle cell, she taught me how to be the sickle cell advocate. And so because I was eager to learn from her, I didn't care mm-hmm. about, you know, who she was or because I was a man and she was a woman and she was telling me what to do and how to be. It's you have to be open-minded, but also communication is really the
definitely
you got to be
sure.
able you got to be able to have
yeah,
that.
Exactly, exactly.
And then all of us, I think, at the panel are in basically male-dominated fields, music, Yeah. You know, that's definitely male-dominated. Comedy?
Yeah.
Come on. I mean, they didn't take me seriously for over 10 years, and I had to start actually doing my work just by using my name, Brooks Jackson.
Yeah.
They thought it was a guy, so I got in some doors. Mm-hmm. But we're in, you know, they want you there, eye candy, or somebody, you know, to talk about or have fantasies about or whatever, but not take you seriously.
Right,
and
right.
That.
And there's old, so many old conversations from the past.
Yeah.
That, I mean, you can date back to centuries that there's been conversations about that. So now either you're a rebel or what when you try to get in that field.
That's true.
So we have to be able to shift even those old conversations to be able to say, you know what? You know, we can share this platform as a male and a female.
Definitely.
And then what do you bring to the table, what I bring to the table, and combine them. Whether you're in charge or not, it shouldn't be whether, you know, who's in charge.
Yeah, exactly. You know, I also, being a military personnel, and being raised by my mom since the age of 5, so, you know, I'm accustomed to how women can take charge and overcome a lot of obstacles that they are presented to. So I don't have a problem when it comes to women. And I'm going to play the devil's side. What gets me is when some women, when they get into these authority positions, they go overboard with it.
That's the other. That's
you
the
know, they
side
go real, you know, and it's like, well, you know, I'm going to draw one position out of the hat because I do take public transportation sometimes, and I find that some female bus drivers
come on now
they get really, you know, inappropriate when it comes to how they treat people.
Wow.
On the bus.
Get your butt on the bus.
You know, you know, I understand they have a time frame and all that. But if you see me standing right there, you know, I mean, you can't open the door. It's like, you know, and then if I bang on the door, you give me a nasty look because of that, you know. It's just, and if I ask you, well, I'm not sure what stop to get off at, and, you know, you look at me like, you know, I shouldn't give you that information. I'm like, well, what is your position? You know, I'll just do that one position out there, but, yeah. You know.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Military-wise, I've met female officers that were like overdoing it, like, yeah. Because sometimes they feel they gotta prove themselves, and
that's
like just
true.
Like, you don't even gotta do that. You don't even take all of that. Like, you don't have to be so hard nosed, you know, with the guys. So, you know, with the male soldiers, because you have to prove your
tough.
Rank or your toughness. Yeah, it's not even that serious. Yeah. You can identify. You notice it when it's happening too. You can tell when it's.
But you got to understand, you know, us women, there's been a lot of struggles from way back into our generation that we've been put down. And with the stigma of us being put down, and when we come to a level of challenges and everything, it's almost like we have to work hard to defend that.
Yeah.
And whether, exactly. Yeah, we have to work hard to defend it, whether it's to the public and we come out maybe very harsh and strong, but it's not like the attention of coming harsh and strong.
But you're defending that conversation.
See, yeah, I'm defending that
conversation. That old conversation.
But I'm defending our women's rights.
Okay.
You see?
Okay.
And because you got to understand the battle that we've been through and everything, all of our struggles. And you don't know what that woman that was driving the bus, what she just, you know, came from dealing
right.
with.
Yeah, exactly.
You
what
know,
her mind
I mean,
at.
She may be carrying something emotional, very hostile, and she cannot, you know, standing on the bus and like, oh, you guys, I'm on PMS today or something or whatever.
You look
you
like
know?
That. You look like one guy. I ain't
you
on
know?
The door for you.
You know, you remind me of my
you remind
ex.
Me of my G.
So
yeah,
you right. are not getting on this
exactly.
bus.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, right?
You know?
Like you don't know.
You don't know. Or somebody who attacked me or
yeah.
something
exactly.
like that. And you got to give it the benefit of a doubt. Like, this person is dealing with something that you might trigger something. Mm-hmm. Okay, and have respect, and that's what I mean about us working together as a unity.
Exactly.
And with the love and the respect that we provide to each other and one another. Mm-hmm. And it's like, have a blessing day.
How do you do that when life is happening? and you're dealing with
and
yourself.
And you deal with it at one person at a time.
Yeah. Right.
So tell me this. Tell me this. Like, you know, the position that you have working at the VA hospital, the challenges that you have to deal with and overcome with your position with male your male counterpart.
Well, with the male counterpart and everything, and it was like, to be honest, I didn't grow up in the military, but I've had a lot of surrounding and my ex-father-in-law and a lot of other people that's been in the military is to understand their suffering. And I've worked in trauma, critical care, and seeing, you know, a limb is off and things like that, and taking care of a patient that has, you know, either no arms, you know, any of their limbs and things like that, and to understand their frustration, what they're dealing with, what they're going through, and providing that compassionate, that the key word is the compassionate, and not just like you giving them the compassionate, but also respect. You know, here you respect, you know, a brother or sister serving their country, and then come back, you know, to struggles. And they have to struggle to defend themselves about everything, about what worthy they have to be accepted and to back into our community.
Well, you said the key word. The key word is compassion. And we're not born with compassion. Some
That's
people
right.
are
not.
Taught. You have to teach.
I thought we were
you
born
have,
with
you
compassion.
You have to teach compassion. And you have to teach people to have compassion for themselves. So if I don't have compassion for myself, how am I going to give it to you?
That's well, that's through faith.
Yeah.
Honey, well, that is that's your faith. You have to want it. I didn't grow up with love. And, you know, professionals will tell me, Myrlene, how do you know how to give love if you didn't grow up with it? You know, and the value of want to be loved and to giving it back to others and everything, and seeing your self-respect and understanding I'm going to treat somebody else how I want to be treated.
Absolutely.
Right.
You know, giving it to others as it's been given unto you.
Absolutely. Yeah. So before we go any further, we have another caller on the line. So we're going to see what this caller is about.
That is they lie.
Yeah. So caller, where's your name? Where you calling from? Question or comment? Hello.
Oh, okay. My name is Talio.
Talio.
I'm calling on behalf of Splashy.
Hey, Talio.
And I'm listening to the conversation, and I just wanted to ask the sister, is it...
It's got three sisters.
Do she think that maybe by her being in the military, does that have anything to do with what she does in a whole, in general, how she conducts herself?
Yeah, I don't
well,
know.
Well, there's
were
three
you in
of
the
us.
Military?
No, I was not in the military. Yeah, I worked with military
personnel.
Okay. Okay. Also, I was listening to something else in the process of me looking at y'all on the Ustream thing, and then when I called in, y'all was talking about the military thing. But in any event, what I feel like this, honestly, and I never ever tried to put sisters down, you know, but from my observation of how sisters are today, I believe that from everything that y'all ever been through in your life, y'all compile all that stuff together. And then with the thing that y'all going through today, y'all take that and add it up, and it makes the relationship harder. Whatever type of relationship you're talking about, it makes it harder. You understand?
True.
But
yeah,
and I understand it. I really honestly do. From a man's point of view, I really honestly understand it. And I try my hardest to help any sister whenever I can on the mental level, emotional, whatever type of level, you know? But that's just my piece, and, you know, that's just what I wanted to say to as far as what I've seen from the news stream. And like I said, I'm just calling on behalf of Splashy because
appreciate it, that's my sister.
I love her to death. I just want to, you know, give her a salute and a shout out and things of that nature. I'm calling from Brooklyn, New York right now.
Brooklyn.
Brooklyn in the house.
Brooklyn.
Hey.
We got New York Talk Live.
Yep.
So that's right.
I just wanted to call and give my salute to all sisters everywhere. I love y'all, man. I will never have nothing else.
Thank you.
Thank you for your question and comment,
my brother.
Thank you.
You know,
right, appreciate it. Thank you for allowing me.
Thank you, my brother.
I think a lot of what he said is true, but we can't do that across the board. You can't lump us into any one category because there's differences. Yeah. It depends on where you grew up, who your parents were, what their values are. I grew up, I was one of those kids who had a mama and a daddy.
Right.
My mama stayed home, my daddy worked. And so I got that. You know, now I try to provide that for my daughter, for my friends, the knowledge that I had. But I was loved. Mm-hmm. I knew I got my ass beat when I did wrong. I got rewarded when I did good. It yeah. was a real family. We don't really have that kind of structure right now. And yeah. young women, and I have a family full of them, it's okay to have a baby and forget about the baby's daddy. Yeah. You know, okay. Who cares? I got my, that's not setting Woo. A good value. Mm-hmm. You know, if there's a reason to forget about him, absolutely right. you do that.
Right,
but
right. Don't let that be the struggle.
That should not right. be.
Yeah.
We need to
the focal point of
communication, back to communication, and yeah. then having compassion for each other,
exactly.
for what we've been through. Don't tell me, because I've had three husbands, that there might not be my perfect mate
right.
somewhere. I didn't choose. I thought I was going to be married to one person forever,
right.
but things come to pass.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we can't live by our past. We have to learn from the past.
Right. Right.
Yeah. Try, and it's up to us who know what it's all about to let young women know. It ain't about getting in a video and shaking your ass, baby. Wait until you get that man that adores you and shake your ass for him.
Yeah. That's right.
Have, you know, put it in some perspective. Don't just allow things to just keep happening and yeah. nobody's saying nothing about it. That's why these platforms are so needed.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes. And we're going to go to another break because we have a few other people in the studio. Give them an opportunity and bring y'all guys back. So this is the Veterans Day Live. This is the Woman Edition. And it's a topic, the battle of the sexes, and you know, and
you gotta have compassion.
Yeah, you know I mean,
you gotta be compassion.
Be compassion.
We gotta get
all
in touch
about
with our feminist side. You know what I mean? It's about getting to our feminist side.
You gotta
side,
be
you know
compassion.
Mean?
No, you gotta learn live compassion.
Yeah,
compassion is a way of being.
You so gotta live it.
You gotta be it first.
You gotta be it.
Be it.
I don't know. I thought we were born
and
with
real
that.
About it. And this nurture and you guys
gotta nurture.
Understand to be it and let your feminine side come out.
All right.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to a break, and that nurture. Phone number to call is 323-473-3100. And it's an interesting show. So you know what I mean. You know we're gonna. Yeah, we're going to go in and we shall return.
Does someone you know have sickle cell disease? Have you heard about the EPIC study? It's an international research study evaluating an investigational drug aimed at shortening the duration of painful crisis. And with over 50 sites in the U.S., there may be a site near you. To learn more and to find out if the EPIC study is right for you, visit www.theepicstudy.com.
Exactly 25 years ago, the United States welcomed 54 million individuals with disabilities into the workforce. And today, even more opportunities exist.
Hi, my name is Dan Jamal Cooper, and I specialize in job placement for individuals with disabilities. I advise on laws, employee rights, and regulations for disabled workers. Meet Rick and Amber Boggs, a visually impaired couple who don't allow their disability to overcome their drive to create jobs for the community.
Dan Juma has been an integral part of our business success, and I believe he is an asset to any business or individual.
Together, we can empower your community and enrich your business. So remember, when it comes to making your business work, make the change today. The Disability Awareness Experts.
SoCalNOMA, the Southern California chapter of the National Organization of Minority Architects, is hosting its 6th annual 3-day summer camp on 3 consecutive Saturdays in August, August 1st, August 8th, and August 15th, for young people ages 10 through 16. Campers will enjoy a 1-day field trip to iconic architectural buildings throughout Los Angeles and 2 days of hands-on building design experiences, including how to use a 3-dimensional computer software program. The total cost of the camp is just $100 per camper and includes lunch, snacks, and it lasts all day from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. To learn more and to register, please go to SoCalNOMA.org. That's SoCalNOMA.org and click on the Camp NOMA page. SoCalNOMA, proud sponsors of LA Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Network.
Hubert's Lemonade, tasty, refreshing, sweet, and tart. Happiness in a bottle. Visit Hubert's Lemonade at hubertslemonade.com. Once again, that's hubertslemonade.com. Happiness in a bottle.
You're listening to the Vaneric Rock Show. I'm your host, Vaneric, daily, Monday through Friday, here only on LA Talk Live. We're more than just talk.
Hi, this is Araceli inviting you to join us every Sunday at 2 p.m. for Veterans Day Live. Join us as we provide info that will help all military personnel. So don't forget to tune in to Veterans Day Live every Sunday at 2 p.m. exclusively on latalklive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, Radio Flag, TuneIn Radio, Live 365, AHA Radio, Table Radio, and Apple TV Radio. Or just watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hello, I'm Joel Ramirez.
And I'm Lolita Robinson Coppage, and welcome to Joy in My House
on LATalkLive.com. Inspirational radio
with a touch of recovery.
A reality show where nothing is left unsaid
and no one is insignificant who says it.
Exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, or watch us on Ustream TV.
Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hey, this is Trisha Mann Grant, and I am inviting you to join us every Sunday at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for Gospel Rhythms, Heaven's Party here on Earth. And join us as we talk to the Christians, just not any Christian, but all Christians of entertainment and all walks of life. Don't forget to tune in to Gospel Rhythms, Heaven's Party here on Earth every Sunday, 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, Live 365, Radio Flag, TuneIn Radio, AHA Radio, TiVo Radio, and Apple TV Radio. Or watch and listen directly at LATalkLive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
All right.
Okay, who assumed that these were all single ladies? I know I'm making an announcement of it about me, but who assumed that?
Well, I'm just putting on. I'm just, you know, see, this song. I played this song as a metaphor of women having their own independence.
Gotcha.
That's why, yeah, single women, as far as being able to do their own thing,
all right,
on their own, they don't need to have anybody to help them.
They can do
it solo.
That's, you know what I mean. Man?
Yes.
For the first time in my life.
Yes.
I am about to move into my own place.
Oh, you're going to love it.
Just me, though. Nobody. Yes. Just, you know, I went from mama and daddy to college roommates to husband. And
that was three.
Okay, and we'll add one more. It was four. And
that's
then, but how exciting. I mean, I think now I'm about to see what women empowerment really means because, wow.
Well, I'll put it like this.
That's wow. What,
you know, you the first time you have your own place, it's nothing. I put it like this: there's no better feeling knowing that when you open up that door, there's nobody on the other side of that door.
Yep.
But you, unless you left them there when you left. When you left. You know what I mean? And then you can just kick your shoes off as
wherever you want to
and just do your thing.
Yeah.
And we got a couple of more people on the panel.
All right.
So we're going to let them announce themselves, starting with the lady on your right.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Phyllis Dixon. And I am an entrepreneur and a Navy brat. My father was in the military, and I feel really honored to be here with you guys as we're honoring veterans and what they contribute.
You said an entrepreneur of what?
I'm an entrepreneur. I do consulting to small businesses as well as to medium-sized businesses and diversity certifications as well as helping them develop their marketing strategies, growth plans.
Okay. All right. And we have what? Marcus who?
What's going on? I'm Marus Fly.
Yes, and who's that gentleman on your left there?
This is my son. This is Isaiah.
Isaiah, what's up, Isaiah? Isaiah's like, look, I want camera time. I want camera time.
My contract says I'm on.
So tell our audience a little bit about yourself, Marcus.
Absolutely. So, you know, I've been involved in somewhat of the in education and the entertainment industry for a while. I know that when I was younger, you know, this is the part that I probably don't want to talk about as much, but I was one of those young cats that had little bit parts on television shows like Parker Lewis Can't Lose and Saved by the Bell and Blossom and little pieces on Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Right.
And had a chance to dance and act and all that. But what was really exciting about, I guess, my life and my career, I'll be very honest and tell you that what happened was I had a long-running commercial that I ran for, what a blessing, was for 5 years for JCPenney. And I was living off of that. I was surviving off of that. And I was, you know, finishing up college at the time and still doing some acting. And my parents really were huge on, hey, you know, you should finish school. And I got to say, you know, that was really the impact of my mother. I mean, my father really kept cracked the whip, you know. But my mother really, you know, her. I guess they say that women have a more nurturing perspective. Mm-hmm. And so she certainly did and nurtured me right on through making sure I finished college. You know, and after that, I got involved in production and worked a lot with ABC News and Universal Pictures and got a job with CBS Television and Dick Clark Productions and BET, you know. And in the midst of it all, you know, it was, you know, I said, is this what this entertainment thing going to be like? You know, going from job to job to job to job, you know. And I thought, from what I remember about my parents, I said, I just want some stability. And I got involved in education and turned out that I loved it. I loved the idea of educating kids. I loved the idea of passing it on, you know, getting kids the chance to sort of to express themselves and getting kids a chance to really become educated, you know. And in that process of educating kids, you know, I couldn't let go of, I guess, my love, my gift, whatever that may be. And I started directing a lot of live shows. And a lot of those live shows was able to get the attention of the school district. And my shows actually toured Los Angeles. I did the huge tour for Hairspray and Annie and Into the Woods. And, you know, I probably can go on and on and on, but it's really not about those. One of the things that happened was the school district station, PBS Television, looked at a lot of the shows that I was doing and decided that they wanted to air the programming. And I said, but I have like 8 shows, you know, Narnia and I got to say that as I was sort of putting it all together, I thought, what am I going to do? So I kind of grabbed a buddy of mine who also was in the business a lot longer than myself. And, you know, we decided to create this documentary film. And this gentleman, if anybody would remember, his name is Rodney Allen Rippey. Rodney was the jack-in-the-box kid.
He was.
You know, who was a star at age 3. Yeah. You know, him and Michael Jackson back at the time. back in the day. And so we came up with this documentary that was that we put together, and we really was trying to organize our direction for how it was gonna go. And I got to tell you, we actually started this production back in 2008, and we just finished the editing in 2014. And we were kind of, you know, in the middle of what's gonna happen next, what's gonna happen next, what are they gonna do? And I'm so happy that I met, you know, Phyllis. We were in the middle of doing, God bless, doing a lot of celebrity interviews. I mean, we had Robert Townsend, Solange Knowles, Beyonce's sister, you know, who came on. We had former mayor Antonio Villaraigosa, Jordan Sparks from, you know, well, she sings a lot now, but I know she won on American Idol. Danny Trejo, Dre? Black Eyed Peas, Cedric the Entertainer, Carol Burnett, Shirley Jones, Dionne Warwick. This little kid, Karan Basah, who was originally from Diary of a Wimpy Kid, and now he's on a show, Bunked, and Jesse for Disney. And so all these people got together and decided to be part of our documentary, you know, and it's called Rise and Shine. And I got to tell you, the power of women are incredible. I got to tell you.
Thank you.
Women are just so powerful, and I don't care who we think we are as men, you know, without a woman, what are you really? You need their support. Phyllis.
Yes.
yes, let's get to Phyllis.
I got to tell you what Phyllis did. Go ahead, Phyllis. Tell them what you told us about our project and what we needed to do next. Go ahead.
Well,
Get in that mic so everybody can hear you.
Get in there, baby.
All right, here it comes. When they brought the project to me, I looked at it. And I asked them what they wanted to do with it. And when they told me what their goal was, they said, well, you need a little work on this. And so I began to share some of my ideas and insight in terms of, especially to be able to generate revenue and to create awareness. That's one of the things I specialize in. They have a really great project. I had first met Rodney Ali Rippey, as a matter of fact, working with him with LA Unified School District, where I was there doing some consulting work of raising awareness with our arts education program. So that's right. How our roads all crossed. And they have a really great project, and so I've been helping them think more strategically about how to fine-tune it, how to market that to the, not only to the educational institutions, but as well to the private sector.
Okay, so tell me this. Mm-hmm. When it comes to you women, yes. Hello, you women over here.
We're listening.
All right. overall, do you think that women, generally women are better organizers than we men in a lot of areas?
Can I weigh in on that first?
Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead.
All right. I think there are big differences between the genders. I think women are hardwired because we're able to give birth and have children that we're wired to multitask.
Mm-hmm.
So number one, just from a biological and physiological standpoint, we have that. But there's always exceptions to the rules because you can run across some women who couldn't multitask to save their lives.
Yeah.
Likewise, there are men, there are those exceptions on the male side. I think women overall, in terms of being business owners or running or managing businesses or in those capacities, tend to be able to do it a lot more effectively because we have emotions, but we don't have the egos to contend with. Some women, but again, there are exceptions to that. And statistically, it's been proven that women business owners are a lot more preferred now in the marketplace because of our ability to be able to find the solution. We're more nurturing. Mm-hmm. We're going to understand our staff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And that's why I put it out there, since Marcus had, you know, he started it. So, you know, because overall, yeah, women, you women can, you know, like you said, multitask and quick thinkers.
And another thing is we have a tendency to kind of work things through.
Right.
You know, like we will, if our employees, if they're working on something and it's not quite working, we'll get in there with them and find a solution. Whereas a man more likely would just give you some more direction and expect you to get it done.
Or
women will be more hands-on, trying to nurture you through what's
exactly. Some men would just say, they would just say, "Oh man, forget about it." You know what I mean? But see, that could be. Yeah. And I'm gonna be the devil's advocate on that because with that said, that can hurt certain women because like within relationships, you know, you're so determined to. You know, fix it and make sure and work it through.
I agree. Absolutely.
Through right. That is draining you. It's so draining. You know, and then the next thing you when it's over and when you've really fed up with it, you're so drained and exhausted.
Yeah, and why didn't I do this 12 years ago?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that happens because women really kind of take it seriously till death do us part, for better, for worse. Yeah. When you actually say that, it really means something. I know it did to me every time I said it, but
I meant it
at the time. So we will keep hacking at it, trying to fix it.
Yeah.
You know, we will do that, and it does sometimes hurt us because, you know, it's clear you should have let that go, but you know, you're determined.
I just picked the relationship, but that's with a lot of things in jobs, careers.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? You women will go all out because of the way you built, and sometimes when it doesn't work out, you know, you come out of it really beat up and exhausted from it.
Can I share just one other perspective on that?
Go ahead.
I grew up in a family with three brothers. No sisters, so I kind of had a different type of perspective and learned how to deal in a alpha male dominated environment, because all three of them were alpha males, including my father. So I learned something that a lot of women don't really early about learning to respect males and let them go at it their pace. And if you do, they'll eventually come to the place you want them to anyway. So I learned how to play that card, which has helped me professionally on an interpersonal relationship and developing relationships when I'm doing business development, understanding and respecting the male for who he is.
Yeah, exactly.
And when I found that when I show that first, it's very easy for them to then reciprocate that
absolutely.
With me.
Right, absolutely.
Yeah, exactly. And me on the other side, because, you know, like I said earlier, my mom's raised me on her own at the age of five. Mm-hmm. I have five sisters. I'm the oldest of all five.
Wow.
And out of the five, I lived in the same household as three. And the first child that the Lord blessed me with is a girl. So, and I had the opportunity to raise her on my own through the state, gave me full custody of her. So,
that's amazing.
Good for you.
By my mother teaching me how to treat women, because I brought this up earlier, how to treat women, I was able to relate with you ladies and understand that you're not controlling me or you know, have that feeling of me you being over me, but also just assisting me and helping me to develop some issues that I may be lacking in. And stuff like that. We talked about how you women have a passage to womanhood that you pass on to the young girls as they get to that point in life. We men, we have a passage to manhood, but we don't practice it as much as you women do. So a young man like him, growing up, if he's not in the right environment or knowing how to be a man, it gets confusing for him. So when he's dealing with women, you know, because if a woman raises him by herself, she can teach him how to treat women.
Right.
But she may not know how to teach him how to be a man, because it's very difficult. Not saying that she can't, but it's very hard for her to teach her son to be a man.
Now let me ask you this: with that, keeping that in mind, what do you think you have done, or what is your plan for teaching your daughter to be a woman? How does that translate for you as her father?
Well, I was told, because I did go through the child service system, to affiliate myself with other single parents, which was 99.9% single women. So I surrounded myself with positive women, because when she got to the age of four or five, I explained to her that her father is not allowed to touch her in certain places. So I had to find a female that I felt comfortable enough to teach her how to take care of herself growing up.
Good.
I taught my daughter at the age of five that boys walk on the inside, girls walk on the inside, boys walk on the outside. And I would deliberately walk out of a building on the wrong side, and this little girl, 5 year old girl, say, "Daddy, you're on the wrong side." Things like that.
That's good.
I Yeah, I did a pretty
How
good
old's
job.
Your daughter?
My daughter's 24 now.
Well, you
and
did.
You better not, you did and good. You better not walk down the street on a, have her walking on the wrong side. But she'll tell you, and she better not let me catch her slipping.
Exactly.
But
now,
yeah.
Does she is she in a relationship? And how did you deal with that at the age of 16 when she was, you know, starting to?
Well, I told her this. I only allow 3 people in front of my house, and you're one of them. So she was only allowed to have 2 other people. If she want, I told her the more information that she gives me, the better chance I'm going to say yes. The less information that she gives me, leave me no other choice but
really?
To say no.
Yeah.
You want to go over your girlfriend's house? How many males is in this house? Who's in the house? I want to go over there, and vice versa. Your girlfriend needs to have her parents come over there to let them see
Absolutely.
What they are. So, unfortunately, she was a victim of her environment. She wanted, because she's my only child, and she got to the age she wanted to live with her mom and her brothers and sister, and being a not inconsistent parent that her mother is, she has 2 sons now.
Your daughter?
Yes. Yeah, I'm a pop twice. Now, she'll tell you, and she'll tell you that if she was with me, she wouldn't have gotten pregnant as she did with her, because I encourage my daughter right now. I use my nephew's 2 sons' mom as an example. She has a doctor's degree, and she got her master's and a doctor degree while raising 2 sons of her own.
It can be done.
And it can be done. So I explained to my daughter, don't think that having these children is going to keep you from
absolutely
accomplishing any level that you want to get to. So
that's right. True.
Yes.
Yeah, definitely,
yes.
Because that's an option.
Yeah.
You have children. That's wonderful. Now let's get out there and make a life for them.
Exactly.
Like what the saying, challenges are opportunity for growth.
Definitely.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
She doesn't need to take that and, to boo-woo or feel down of herself that she cannot accomplish, goal. And, okay, fine. She have those 2 beautiful children, which is your grandchildren.
Yeah.
Now, to provide her with the support and the love that she needs and encouraging her, she could continue to build herself and better herself.
Yeah, because I tell her in a minute, when I'm broke, you're broke. When I'm paid, you're paid. Because this one, as a young, when she was younger, I had a working at a synagogue in Lower Marion, Pennsylvania, and we had a daycare. They had like a little daycare center there, and I was able to get her to help one of the teachers. So every Friday, what I would do, I would go to the office and put some money in the envelope, or have the lady who was in charge of paying us call her on the intercom to have her come up to the office so she can get paid. To teach her that when you do these things, you have to work to get these things. So, so this
there's
is what
there's a value in kids don't know it. Unfortunately, single parents and mothers I know to be guilty of that, because I was a single parent for my daughter for a while. You overcompensate, and that does not always lead to the best result, because the kid expects things, nothing.
For doing
they
nothing.
Just, they want stuff.
Yeah, and I'm going to say this one more day, and I'm going to let y'all go. Like I used to tell my daughter, I said, look, Friday, you know what time I'll walk through that door. All right? So if you want to get paid, when you out there with your girlfriend, you either tell one of your girlfriends, look, come with me to, because I got some business to take her, or I'll be right back. Because if you're not in, when I walk in that door and you're not there, I'm going to give you a few minutes. And if you're not here at a certain time, then you got to wait.
That's right.
Just like they tell me at the end of the day, they tell me at the office, they say, look, come pick up your check before 4:00. If I come 5:04, the door is locked. I got to wait till Monday to get my money. So I would tell her the same thing.
Yeah.
Well,
I
know for me, growing up, I was a young mother. And I got married young, and I had a choice to make, and I decided, I knew I was going to have to work, so I opted, I says, I can put school on hold because I didn't want to try and be the super mom and take even more time away from my daughter. And it can be done, so your daughter, you mm-hmm. should, she should be, because every job that I had, I looked at it as, I had the mindset, they're paying me to go to school. On the job. I graduated from the University of On the Job Training, and I've been able to grow successful businesses.
There you go. There you go.
I mean, I have. When I started my first company, we did project and construction management as well as real estate consulting. I've been in places that somebody who doesn't have, I don't have the paper behind my name that says I should be in that, but it took a lot of hard work.
Of course.
And I determined that I wasn't going to continue to make those same mistakes. And, you know, and it's carried me a long way. I mentor a lot of young women now. Mm-hmm. I'm working with a young lady now. She's a young mother. I says, get your GED. I says, I'm not hiring till you get your GED.
Yeah. There you go.
But you have to stick with them. And really hard, all labor is profitable.
Yeah. Right.
All labor is profitable. So your daughter will be fine.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, you know, exactly. And my daughter's been diagnosed with bipolarism. Mm-hmm. And she called me a couple of days ago, said, Dad, I finally passed my driver's test. I got my permit. I said, okay, that means we got to go car shopping soon, right? Uh-huh. So she, you know, it's just words of encouragement. My daughter's back in Lancaster, Pennsylvania with the Amish people. And so I give her words of encouragement on a regular basis. Mm-hmm. But, you know, we getting ready to come to an end of this.
No.
This,
Oh,
so we're going to bring, we're going to try to bring in as many people back in, you know what I mean, as possible.
I'm trying to share one more thing before we go about Rise and Shine. It is airing on PBS television coming this September.
Yay.
Check it out. Also, we're finishing up an Indiegogo campaign to finish raising some last-minute funds for the film and to pay for some licensing. So if you get a chance to go on the net and go on to Indiegogo, look up Rise and Shine. Check us out. Support, support, support. We need you. And the more women, the better. That's what I say.
Yeah. All right.
And fellas, go ahead, give us some last shout-outs, how people can get in contact with you.
You can get a hold of me. My company name is Thomas Webster & Associates. My email address, thomaswebster.mc@gmail.com. Or you can give me a call. You can reach me at 562-208-4315. Look forward to hearing from you.
All right. Awesome. Go ahead, Ms. Brooke.
It's not that time of the month. It's all female comedy tour. We are looking to tour military bases where we will be giving back all the money raised from the shows to military to organizations that assist military women and women veterans. So we will be starting a GoFundMe account within the next 30 days. We'll be talking about it. But support military veterans.
There you go.
Definitely. And I'm with Women Network, womennetwork.com, and / event. We have our monthly event also in Irvine and one in Pasadena. And we are all over the world, and it's empowering women. Our five areas is for physical, which is also dealing with any, you know, medical or any type of financial, career, social, and community, giving out all to the community. Check our website, womennetwork.com, also California Women's Conference.com, women's with ENS. Thank you very much.
There you go. Thank you. There you go. So we're going to go to a quick break and bring some more people back. You know what I mean? I might have to have everybody sitting around, whatever, but we're going to give out some more last-minute shout-outs. So this is Veterans Day Live. Thank you for listening, and we'll be right back.
This is
the women's edition, so I don't know. I'm gonna play some more independent stuff. We'll be right back.
Something from a woman.
Yes.
Lucy Liu with my girl Drew, Cameron D and Destiny, Charlie's Angels. Come on. Question. Tell me what you think about me. I buy my own diamonds and I buy my own rings. Only ring your celly when I'm feeling lonely. When it's all over, please get up and leave. Question, tell me how you feel about this. Try to control me, boy, you get dismissed. Pay my own funnel and I pay my own bills. Always 50-50 in relationships. The shoes on my feet, I bought. The clothes I'm wearing, I bought. The rock I'm rocking, I bought. Cause I depend on me if I want it. The watch I'm wearing, I bought. The house I live in, I bought. The car I'm driving, I bought.
All the women who independent, throw your hands up at me. All the women.
Girl, I didn't know you could be down like that. Oh, yes, indeedy. We're back. This is Veterans Day. This is Veterans Day Live. Women's empowerment segment of the show for veterans, because like I said earlier, women need a platform, and Farron and I came up with this idea to do this, and he also has Trench Talk himself along with his sickle cell and stuff like that. So like I said, this is near the end of the show, so we're going to go ahead and close this out with some last remarks. So go ahead. I mean, this is y'all show, ladies. This is all y'all ladies.
Ladies, you gotta beat compassion. That's where I left off.
Come on now, ladies.
Compassionate. We the women. And empowerment. You know, to be loving, respect, trust, unity, and to bring that into our homes and to our community for each other. Brothers out there, when you see your sisters, just show a little respect and say hello, good afternoon, good morning. It's not yo baby, what's up? Just leave that out.
Preach.
You know. Thank you very much.
There you go. Go ahead, TJ.
Well, you know, I'm back after like 45 minutes. Let's see. No, I think, you know, women, for the caller that called earlier talking about women bringing their past issues into the present, I do feel that women should leave the past in the past, learn from it, like one of our other guests said, and move on and, you know, live in the present, you know, not in the past. And hopefully we can talk more about that in the next segment.
Yeah. Go ahead, Splash.
All right. I just want to say thank you for allowing me to be here. And look for my mixtape, which should be coming out the beginning of next year. You can contact me on Instagram. It's Splashy1980. My Facebook is Shakeelia Splashy Fuller. And my email is Keela, K-E-E-L-I-A, 1980 at Gmail. Please feel free to hit me up anytime about anything you have. And I'm looking for artists, anybody who's willing to be on my mixtape that I'm hosting. Thank you for being here.
There you go. Outstanding. Go ahead, Farron.
You know, LA Talk Live, we're more than just talk. I think a lot of even the world issues, especially on the media aspect, and that's why I love this network, because we get to shift those conversations. Even the other stuff we're talking about are all like the end results. But what about when you go back to the basics of, go back to that person. Before you get into this argument or disagreement, find out what's going on with that person. Then you can, all that stuff will disappear. By the time you have those conversations, you'll be like, well, no wonder you're having a bad day like that. Then you can go from there and have a totally different conversation instead of everybody's bumping heads and surviving life. Nobody's living life. We say it, but how do we really live life? You gotta be it.
Right.
There's survival and you gotta live. Exactly. But we say it, but we're human beings, not human doings. Drop the mic.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yes. Okay.
Okay. Well, I just want to say.
Go ahead.
Absolutely.
Pick the mic back up.
You can have my seat. No, come have
me. No. I can be right here. Thank you for having me. I look forward to coming back to LA Talk Live. I miss you guys. My show will be starting in October.
Okay.
So look for a necessary conversation with Brooks Jackson Colyar right here on LA Talk Live, where we are more than just talk.
Reality radio.
And I just want to close out. Go ahead.
Also, we will have a Women Network and a talk show right here in LA Talk Live. So our pilot should be going off soon.
That's right. And she's looking for a name right now. And then the name she's fooling around with is Talk Therapy.
Okay.
So if you got any ideas.
All right. I'll think of something.
I'll think of something.
Yeah.
Something.
And I'm going to close out with saying this. Ladies, be empowered. Stand up for what you believe in. But when that guy opens the door for you, just turn around and say thank you. Even if you're having a bad day.
That's right.
Even if you're having a bad day, man, you know, say thank you.
Passion.
You know what I mean? If a guy sees you walking down a small street, you know, pavement, and he stops to let you go by first, say thank you. Yes. He's not trying to attack you.
He's trying to look at your butt. That's all. I'm just kidding.
You know what I mean? So you know what I mean? Hey. Just think about. Just think that chivalry's not there. You know, they are gentlemen. And with that said, man, thank you for listening.
Thank you
ladies, for being there.
All right.
Veterans Day Live.
Veterans Day Live.
You know how we do the building.
And all that. Stay tuned.
for gospelrhythms.com.
Well, they got a whole cast.
Roll Williams, she's in the house. She act like she don't want to say nothing.
Oh, hey, there she go.
There she go. There she, you know what I mean? There she is.
She,
you
got
know
a
mean?
Whole, she got a whole cast out there.
Now that's how you, that's how you introduce yourself.
There you go. So thank you, everybody.
Thank I'm you,
I'm gonna close with Hal Melvin. Wake up, everybody. Wake up.
DPG.
Who ain't got no women?
What's the count?
All right.
Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh, a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can. The world won't get no better if we just let it be. Na 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 na. We gotta change it now, just you and me. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hair. But they don't have so very long before their judgment day. So won't you make them happy before they pass away? Time to build a new